friends, welcome back to Techie Minds. And today in this video, I'll be telling you 5 cool WhatsApp tricks. So let's start with the video. The first trick, how to read messages without letting anyone know. So WhatsApp already has a feature of turning your read receipt off, but that feature doesn't allow you to read messages without letting others know in WhatsApp groups. So for doing this, first we have to open WhatsApp web in your PC. So I'll open the browser and type web.whatsapp.com. Now I want to see the messages of this group without letting anyone know. So first we have to turn off your internet connection. Now you can see the internet of my PC is turned off. Now I'll open this group and read the messages that I want. This trick only works for text messages. Now I have read the messages, so I'll put the WhatsApp web on reload. It's showing no internet, and after waiting for 2 to 3 seconds, I turn the internet back on. This ensures that the PC does not send the phone the information that the message has been read. Now I'll click on reload again. So after reload, you will still see the messages unread. It will show unread in the phone to others too. The next trick. How to see if anyone has read your message when their read receipt is turned off. So I sent a few messages with my other phone's read receipt turned off. You can see my other phone has seen the messages, but still I'm not getting the double blue tick sign. Now I want to check whether the other phone has read the message or not. So for this trick, you have to send a voice message to the user. The voice message may be empty. And now, as soon as the other user plays the voice message, you can see the blue tick has come. Later you can claim that the voice message was sent by mistake. The next trick, emoji shortcut on WhatsApp web. This one is not basically a trick, it's just a shortcut which may help you in typing faster during conversation in WhatsApp web. Suppose I'm typing a message to this number and I want to add an emoji after the text. I now have to go to the emoji button and search through the whole list of emoji, or I have to search it. Instead of doing this, what you can do is simply add a colon and now search for the emoji you want. Like currently I want to add a smile emoji, so I'll just type smile and it will show all the emojis related to it. Now simply click on the emoji you want and press enter. Quick and easy. The next trick. Auto clicker. This is my favorite one. So when your friend doesn't respond immediately when you want him to, you can use this as a prank. What it will do is, you can send repetitive message to someone without typing again and again. So first, we need to download this app called AutoClicker. Download links in the description. So first open Play Store or App Store. Now search for AutoClicker. Now download this first app. After downloading, open the app and give it all the permission it asked for. Now set the target mode to multi-target mode. Now you'll see the panel on the left of your screen. Let's open WhatsApp now. Suppose I want to annoy this friend of mine. So I'll open the chat and click on plus icon. It will add a click on my screen. So I'll drag it to the letter H. And add another click and drag it to letter I. And now I'll add the last click to send. The send button will be here when the message has been typed. Now I hold the third click and adjust the delay, because WhatsApp has a slower response time as compared to the click speed. So I'll set it to around 500 milliseconds. Now when I'll click on this play icon, it will start the click cycle which will loop until stop. So now you can keep sending the person messages until he responds. You can also use this app for other clicking purposes too. The last one, sending using WhatsApp documents. WhatsApp has a media send limit of 16 MB in the phones and 64 MB in the WhatsApp web. Also, the WhatsApp compresses the images and video files and also changes their format. So the ultimate solution is sending through WhatsApp documents. So for doing this, go to the link icon and now select documents. Now either you can select any document file or click on browse other documents to see all types of media. Now you can select any media that you want to send and click on send. Done. Now this media has been sent in its original quality, format and resolution. And using this, you can send files up to 64 MB in phone storage. So that's all for this video. Thank you for watching Techie Minds. Do like, subscribe and share. Also, do not forget to comment. Thank you.